AITA. Am I the a-hole for refusing to stop having a relationship with my bio daughter because my girlfriend is uncomfortable? I've known my best friend Brenda since we were kids. I was the first person she came out to as a lesbian when we were in our senior year of high school and fully supported her. She met her current wife in college and they got married 6 years later. When I was 27, they both talked to me about wanting to start a family. They asked if I would consider being their sperm donor because they wanted someone they trusted rather than a stranger and who'd be there when their child started to have questions about their donor. I was honored that they thought of me and agreed to do it. It felt good to help people I care about start their own family. We went through the whole process and a year later, Brenda gave birth to their daughter, Lucy, after Lucy Lawless of course, haha. Since she was born, I've always been present in her life and we have a great uncle/niece type relationship. The three of us have been happy with how things are and they're glad I'm close with Lucy. She's already been told of how she came into the world, without the full details, and while she knows I helped build their family, I'm still Uncle Steven to her. 3 years after she was born, I began dating my girlfriend. I didn't tell her about Lucy till 4 months in and it took her time to process this but she eventually came around. We've been together 3 years now and planning on getting married. Last week was Lucy's 6th B-day and we both were at their house. After cake was cut, we all started taking pics. I told my GF to come so we both could get one with Lucy but she said no. Didn't think nothing of it until I noticed she was distant and hardly interacting with anyone. We talked after we got home and she said she didn't feel comfortable with me seeing Lucy anymore because it still felt weird that I donated sperm and now I'm playing a role in her life when donors don't do that. This was a shock to me because she never brought it up before. When I said I wasn't gonna stop, she got frustrated and it became a huge fight. She didn't understand why I had to be in Lucy's life and it felt unfair that she has to share me with someone who's not my legal responsibility. At one point she asked if Brenda and I slept together and came up with this donor idea to cover the fact that I knocked her up, and that's why I'm involved. I get we were both angry but asking that was out of line. I told her I'll never cut off my relationship with them and left our apartment. She's still been trying to convince me for days and to also consider her feelings in all this. To her, it's unreasonable to choose a kid that'll never truly be mine over her, someone I can have a future and a family with. I feel bad that she feels this way, but it seems like she's not being fair either. It's been rough and I don't know who's right or wrong. She's making me feel like the bad guy here and I need a neutral party's help. AITA? Am I the a-hole? Wow. Your girlfriend is angry you have a relationship with your biological child. You are NTA, not the a-hole. And you do not want to have any kind of permanent relationship with someone who would sever your ties to your biological child. Run, and run now. NTA. Not the a-hole but I also don't see how you two are compatible from this standpoint. This seems like an impasse, and something your GF thought she was okay with and changed her mind, or didn't know of the full scope of what she was getting into when she said it was fine with her. But you do what is right for you. Anyone trying to change that, especially when, IIRR, you've been in her life before your GF was in yours, well, that's asking a lot. It's asking a lot of you to expect you to ghost this little girl. And it's selfish too. If your GF wanted to be in your life, she would be happy to share you with a 6-year-old girl who has a life of her own, not asking you to ghost her. NTA. Not the a-hole but why is she uncomfortable? I don't like that she doesn't trust you either, that's a big red flag if you ask me. You have every right to have an uncle/niece relationship with Lucy, even if you weren't her biological father, which I don't think matters anyway. I wish you can sort this out, but take care, my man. I think it's that Lucy, her mom's, and I are kinda like our own little family of sorts because of how close we are and doesn't like that our lives would always be linked with theirs. Which again still doesn't make sense to me because that is basically everyone's families. Brenda is my family and I also always said I'd still love Lucy the way I do now no matter who her donor is. Thank you, I really do wish to figure all this out. NTA. Most people recognize that it is possible to love many people and love is not a zero-sum game. Sadly, some people do not. It sounds like your girlfriend is one of those. NTA. It felt unfair that she had to share me with someone who's not my legal responsibility. How is this unfair? You're a person. You get to have your own friends, relationships, history, etc., demanding you cut that off in the absence of abuse, emo that's way over the line. She's the one that wants to force you to pick. There's nothing about maintaining your friendship with Brenda and being an uncle to her kid that also means you can't have a family with her. It'll just be a bigger family, and how is that a bad thing? And hell, plenty of people are stand-in uncles and aunts to kids who have no legal relationship at all. NTA. I'm going to risk some downvotes and play devil's advocate for a minute. Your fiancé starts dating you as a single guy with no children, and over time she finds out that you have a niece who is really a bit more than a niece. At the birthday party, with the wedding more of a certainty, it sinks in that you are not really unattached. I don't think she is right at all to react like an a like she did, but I can understand feeling a little overshadowed in her position. Lucy means you are tied to a city, tied to her mom's, and your fiancé's needs are just not as important. What if a job comes up for her elsewhere? All trips from here on out will have to take into account graduation ceremonies and school vacations. If you have kids, it will be a first for her, but not for you. I'm not trying to justify her reaction, because she's definitely the but I can see how she might feel a bit slighted in this situation. Honestly, I think she should be looking at the positives, and seeing this bonus family for the wonderful thing it is. You guys should all get along well, you could have trusted babysitters, and reciprocate, or course, and the fact that you are close friends with women tells me that you are more empathetic than a lot of other men. You need to have a talk with her and find out if she was having a tantrum or if she really expects you to punish an innocent 6-year-old for existing. NTA. Your GF is threatened by a child. Does she think you don't have enough love to go around? NAH. No a-holes here. You said your girlfriend eventually came around, but she clearly didn't. Not everyone wants to date someone who effectively already has a kid, so this clearly was just the catalyst for the two of you to go your own separate ways. Side note, good on you for being in the kid's life. NTA. I'm glad your girlfriend is addressing this now before you're married, but big red flag. Sounds like she has some trust issues, and rather than being proud of this wonderful gift you gave your friends, she thinks you had other intentions. NTA at all. It's great that you're in her life from the start because that's what works for you and Brenda. Obviously a lot of sperm donors are strangers so that wouldn't work for them. Honestly you sound like you have a sweet relationship with Lucy and I don't think it's worth ending that for someone because they're uncomfortable. NTA but I'd stop calling her your daughter. I normally don't, trust me. I just didn't know how else to explain the nature of our relationship in the title without going over the character limit. NAH. No a-holes here. Most sperm donors are not involved. To some people this is a weird situation. I don't think she was out of line to ask that question because it is possible. When you agreed to be your friend's sperm do it, did you ever discuss or think what would happen if you started a relationship with someone who wasn't okay with this? What if you were with your girlfriend at the time and she wasn't comfortable with you doing this? Have a relationship with your niece/bio daughter that works with you and her mom's. If you do want to cut off contact or distance yourself, don't. Do realize this is a deal breaker to some people, and in the future this might be something you bring up early on. NTA. Not the a-hole. This is literally my husband's family dynamic. His moms wanted to have a baby and used their best friend as a donor. His bio dad has always been a part of his life and has always been there as a support for his two moms. Do not push away the kid for a relationship. Growing up, my husband loved knowing his bio dad and having a relationship with him. His moms are definitely his parents, but knowing his bio dad and having a relationship with him meant so much to him growing up. Please don't push this little girl away. I have seen how this all plays out if you stay in the picture, and from my perspective it has made my husband a better person knowing that there are so many people in his life loved him and were there for him. NTA. You aren't the a-hole for continuing to see what you consider to be family because your girlfriend is jealous of a 6-year-old. Honestly, this sounds like some emotionally abusive nonsense and is a very good reason to completely reevaluate the relationship. If she's jealous of a 6-year-old and attempting to manipulate you into not seeing your family, she's got to go. NAH. No a-holes here. I understand her concern. She might feel that if you both have kids one day, this kid that is kind of your kid but not really, is going to affect your relationship with your family with her. And she's probably not wrong. I understand that you want to be in this kid's life, and that's good. But from her perspective, you'll always have a priority that is just as high, if not higher, than her and any future family you might make together. NTA. It's a total bait and switch for her to suddenly not be okay with this, after previously pretending to be okay with it. Lucy is a part of you, and your life, always. Time to call off the wedding. NTA. The implication that you had sex with Brenda and you're tethered to them now honestly would ruin the relationship, if it were me, considering the fact that you told her you were a donor 3 years ago. Regardless of the fact that you aren't taking on a traditional father role to Lucy, she, Brenda, and her wife are your family. You don't ask your significant other to turn their back on family unless there is something toxic/drastic/unhealthy going on. This situation is none of those. It's horrible that your girlfriend waited this long to say she had a problem with it. Almost like she was maybe waiting for you to get more attached to her and more likely to do as she asks. Keep Lucy and Brenda. Ditch the GF. She sounds awful. Oh, and I love how Lucy was named, by the way.